Hey, Rob Boehner, producer at LiveX here, and today I've got an unboxing of the Blackmagic Ursa Mini 4K PL. It's a pretty sexy little camera. It gives you really good capture and a really good look for your client. Opening the box. Welcome to Blackmagic Design. DaVinci Resolve Studio. I think Blackmagic just wants to give out a copy of that to everyone in the world because we have so many of these little SD cards, and really it's kind of a waste because you can just download DaVinci Resolve Studio online. And before we get into this camera right here, we're gonna open this power supply box. So there's the power supply, it comes with an IEC. It also comes with the ability to rewire it to the back of the camera permanently if you're putting it in some sort of studio application or industrial application. Standard 4-pin power. This is the Ursa Mini. Comes with a really nice handle as well as this paddle type viewfinder. It's essentially a Blackmagic Video Assist on the side of the camera. It's about the same size. I think it probably is the exact same size. And then on the side of the camera here, we have our CFast card inputs, as well as your menu options, iris focus peaking program. That's for return video. One of the things that's really nice about the Ursa Mini for live is that you can send TalkBack, Tally, and return program back to the Ursa Mini from an ATEM switcher. These are your audio levels, and most everything else is done in the onboard menu itself. This is the top plate, has quarter 20 mounting holes, four of them. Your audio inputs under here, your XLR. It's a little weird to get your XLR in on top of the camera and then point down. But your power is on the side, it's not on the back. And your SDI out, this is 12G SDI out for 4K signal transmission. And this on the back, it looks a little crude and rudimentary, other than the overall slick design of the camera body itself. But basically, this is designed so you can put a V-mount battery plate over the top or adapt it to some other kind of power in the back. On the side here, you have another SDI out, an SDI in. This SDI in, that's for your DaVinci Resolve color correction inside of the ATEM. Your reference is down here, but the SDI in can also be used for your return program. This is another power adapter in the back. This is your lens control if you were gonna adapt a PL to B4 lens. And let's see if there's anything else in the box over here. We got just the hand grip wristband, as well as your LANC control for the remote. This is how you would toggle it back and forth. That's it for the Blackmagic Ursa Mini 4K PL. Once again, I'm Rob Boehner with LiveX. Thanks for watching.